Learn how to find the area of a parallelogram, triangle, trapezoid, and rhombus.
What's the formula to find the area of a parallelogram?
The formula for the area of a parallelogram is given as the length of the base times the height. The base and the height are always perpendicular to each other. So why is this formula true? If we cut off the triangle from one end of the parallelogram and slide this over to the other side, a rectangle is formed. The area has not changed. It was simply rearranged to form a rectangle with the same base and height. Since the area of a rectangle is found by multiplying the base and height, the area of a parallelogram is found the same way.
What about the area formula for a triangle?
Let's figure that out. Start with a triangle of any shape or size. If we make a copy of that triangle and then rotate it around one of the sides, a parallelogram is formed. Two congruent triangles form the parallelogram, so the area of one triangle is half the area of the parallelogram, or one half times the base times the height. The area of the triangle depends only on the lengths of the base and height, not all three sides. So any two triangles that have the same base and height will always have the same area.
What about finding the area of other kinds of quadrilaterals?
There are two other quadrilaterals that you should know the area formulas for, a trapezoid and a rhombus. Let's start with a trapezoid. If we create a second trapezoid and rotate it just as we did for the triangle, we form a parallelogram again. The height of the parallelogram is the same as the height of the trapezoid. The base of the parallelogram is the length of B1 plus B2. So the area of one trapezoid is one half the area of the parallelogram, or one half times the base, B1 plus B2, times the height.
Can the area of a rhombus be found using a parallelogram as well?
Remember, a rhombus is a parallelogram with four congruent sides. So you can always use the formula for a parallelogram, base times height, to find the area. But the rhombus also has a unique area formula involving the diagonals. The area of a rhombus can be found by taking one half the product of the two diagonals. In other words, the area equals one half times D1 times D2. Let's look at why this is true. The diagonals of a rhombus are perpendicular and they bisect each other. So four congruent right triangles are formed by the diagonals. Watch how the area of one triangle is used to calculate this area formula for a rhombus.
Would you do a couple problems?
Certainly. Let's begin with the following. To find the area of this parallelogram, we need to identify what is the base and what is the height. Remember, the base and the height must be perpendicular to each other. So for this problem, use the side with length 5 inches as the base with the height of 8 inches. Notice that the parallelogram does not always have to sit on the base. So the area is 5 times 8, or 40 square inches. For this problem involving a trapezoid, substitute the appropriate values into the area formula. The area is 144 square meters. To find the area of this rhombus, we must first determine the lengths of the two diagonals. Since the diagonals in a rhombus bisect each other, one must have a length of 10 yards, while the other has a length of 14 yards. The final answer is 70 square yards. Now, once you understand why these area formulas are true, problems involving multiple steps or multiple figures do not have to be so challenging.